Good morning, everyone. I'm Reg Helwer, Minister of Central Services and the MLA for Brandon West. I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge that we are in Treaty 2 territory, home of the Métis Nation. Thank you to all who are joining us for this announcement today. My colleague, the Honourable Rochelle Squires, Minister of Families, my colleague Len Eastleson, MLA for Brandon East, His Worship, Rick Chrest, Mayor of Brandon, and Mr. Kirk Brugger. Thank you all for joining us and welcome to Brandon. It's indeed an exciting day here in Manitoba as we continue to strive towards providing affordable housing to vulnerable Manitobans across the province. I now invite Minister Squires to the podium to give remarks. Minister.
Thank you. It's always such a pleasure to be in Brandon. Thank you for that, Reg. Okay, good morning, and thanks to my colleague and friend, Minister Helwer, for that introduction and for having us here in Brandon West, as well as our colleague Len Eastleson, the MLA for this area, and the MLA for Brandon East, for hosting us in their great city. I want to start by recognizing my colleagues with the federal government in this initiative and thanking them for their partnership with this announcement. And finally, I'd also like to thank Mayor Rick Chrest, who has always been a strong advocate for the city of Brandon. It is always great to see you, and it is great to be back in the Wheat City today. As I'm sure my colleagues will agree, affordable housing creates benefits that last a lifetime and strengthens an entire community. That is why today I'm pleased to announce that government is partnering with the Government of Canada and the City of Brandon to create new affordable housing units for low-income families here in Brandon. All 48 units in the planned new complex will be two-bedroom, and I'm extremely pleased to note that all 48 units will be for low- to moderate-income families. In addition, as Minister responsible for accessibility, I'm extremely pleased to see that 8 of the units on the main floor will be accessible for persons with disabilities. The governments of Canada and Manitoba are providing $780,000 in capital funding for this project, which will be built on the site of the former Fleming School. This $780,000 investment is made possible through the National Housing Strategy Bilateral Agreement, which was signed by the governments of Canada and Manitoba in 2019 to ensure families, Indigenous communities, and vulnerable Canadians can count on long-term funding for community housing in Manitoba. Another $780,000 will be provided next year for a total of $1.6 million through the bilateral agreement. The above noted bilateral investment enabled 24 of the 48 units in this project to be affordable. I'm very pleased to note that the City of Brandon, using funds granted by our provincial government, has approved an additional $1.56 million to make the entire project, all 48 units, fully affordable housing for Brandon residents. This $1.56 million fund from the provincial government comes from the approximately $4 million that the City of Brandon received from the province earlier this year. Funding of $12 million was granted to 10 of the largest municipalities in Manitoba outside the City of Winnipeg to address gaps left by the federal government's rapid housing initiative, of which only Winnipeg in the province of Manitoba was a recipient of this funding. I am so pleased to see this funding going to such a worthy project, and I want to take this opportunity to recognize and thank the City of Brandon for their work and for providing the land, which is a significant contribution to this development. Construction on the project is expected to begin in spring of 2022, and I look forward to receiving and sharing updates on this development as it moves forward. Our government continues to make important investments in affordable housing so that all families in Manitoba, including those with lower incomes, can have a safe place to call home. Since 2016, we have supported the creation of 743 new affordable and social housing rental units. We have also supported home ownership for more than 220 households through partnerships with municipalities, nonprofit organizations, and other organizations. As part of that, our government has invested more than $5.2 million to develop 96 new rental, cooperative, or single-family homes for families in Brandon since 2018. our government will continue to protect and support vulnerable Manitobans all across this province through the development of affordable, accessible housing. I look forward to future collaborations with our federal, municipal and community partners to create more affordable housing options here in Manitoba. Thank you, and back to you, Minister Helwer.
Thank you, Minister Squires, indeed a great announcement, and thank you for coming to Brannan. It's a project that we've been working on for a while, and I now pleased to introduce His Worship Rick Chrest, Mayor of Brannan, to say a few words. Mayor?
Thank you very much, Minister Reg. Madam Minister Rochelle Squires and MLA Len Islison, along with our colleague here, Mr. Kirk Brugger, who we're going to hear from quite shortly. This is certainly a fabulous day. This is a very sizable project, and as you can see, in a tremendous setting, it'll be a beautiful, practically infill development, and the city of Brannan is very proud to be part of, and more importantly, very grateful for both the federal and provincial government's input on this, as well, in this case, the very proactive involvement on the part of the private developer, Mr. Kirk Brugger and his company. The provision of housing in our nation is certainly a profound responsibility and certainly a complicated scenario in every locale in our great nation, given the high costs of construction and availability of land, and consequently, in my view, it's been required that everyone kind of does a little piece of this. And so we found the most success when we do have all three levels of government that are able to collaborate, and this particular project is a sort of a sterling example of that. The federal government, provincial government, the local government are all providing either funding and or land to make this happen. And in this particular case, well, lots of the projects are fully government or government in cooperation with nonprofit organizations. This particular great project involves the private sector with an entrepreneur stepping forward. He's a community-minded individual that also recognizes the need for affordable housing. This particular site, of course, as we are calling it, the Fleming School site, was occupied by a local school, Fleming School, for many decades. And when the Brannan School Division determined that it was no longer required of them, the arrangement that the city and the school division generally have, the city generally provides the land for the construction of schools, and when they're, if they're ever no longer available or required rather, the land is largely transferred back to the city, and great use can be made of it. So in this particular case, the school actually still stands and occupying a portion of the site and is being used by a local First Nation. Two tremendous commercial buildings have been developed on the property that face Victoria Avenue, and now a very significant affordable housing project will be developed on the remaining piece. So just tremendous broad use of this land, very sensitive to the neighborhood. To that end, I would like to acknowledge the ward councillor of this neighborhood, City Councillor Sean Cameron. So thank you very much for attending. And I would also like to thank and acknowledge the work of our Director of Economic Development, Ms. Sandy Trudell, who does tireless work on these kind of files, and I know worked very hard with the developer and with the government to piece this together. These projects are often a game of inches when it comes to the finances and the math, and it did take a very careful consideration of the financial piece of this to make it all work, but we're so thrilled to see it all come together, and a spectacular, fully affordable housing project will come to fruition quite shortly. So once again, thank you, Minister Squires, for bringing this announcement today. And like you, I would also like to thank our federal representatives who I believe are likely part of the streaming Member of Parliament Terry Duguid, as well as Member of Parliament Adam Vaughan, and we thank everyone for putting their shoulder to the wheel to make this happen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Chrest, on behalf of the Manitoba government, and thank you to everyone for joining us today and for your commitment and dedication to Manitobans. We now have the developer, Kirk Brugger. He's been very patient on this since he first acquired the project or the property. It was quite a complex piece of land with a couple of different owners, and working with Sioux Valley, I know, on the school and other development interests, and always wanting to do something good for Brandon. So Kirk, please come forward with some remarks.
Thank you very much, Reg. Mine will be a little bit more informal. Thank you, Minister Squire. Thank you, Len, Rick Chrest. And I do also want to acknowledge Sandy Trudell. Sandy was an intricate part of making this happen. And my project manager, Damon McGilvery, has been fantastic on putting this together. Over a decade ago, we started this project looking for doing something for the community. I love the city of Brandon, love this community, love the people in it. And affordable housing is close to my heart, and I believe that this project in itself will provide families in this area a beautiful place to live and a great community to be part of. And I want to thank the federal government, provincial government, and the city of Brandon for all their hard work and dedication. It's been a lot of work, but at the end of the day, it's something for this community to grow and build upon, and I'm very thankful for everyone that's been involved in this project. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Kirk. That now concludes the formal portion of our program, unless there's questions, but we can stop for a photograph. And thank you everyone for coming today. It is indeed a great announcement for Brandon and all of Westman. And I'm very pleased that we were able to put this all together. Sandy Trudell was, as you mentioned, a great proponent on everyone's behalf, making sure we were all aware of what was happening and what needed to happen next. Minister Squires worked hard with her department and the federal government to pull this all together. So we're quite happy that we're at this place today. Thank you.